Broadcasting live from Houston, Texas, where the retractable roof of Minute Maid Park is closed. It's Game 1 of the World Series between the L.A. Dodgers and the Houston Astros. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. It's the moment these players have been waiting for. Game 1 of the Fall Classic is on the show, and it's coming up next. Zach Greinke gets the call on the mound here at home for Game 1 of the World Series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, we're taking a look at one of the top pitchers in the game. This guy has over 200 career victories, and he'd like to add another one to this list. This guy's been a really good pitcher for a long time, and right now, he's showing no signs of slowing down. It'll be interesting to watch him work in this one here.
Here's Mookie Betts, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Pass and misses. That strike two.
He was able to sneak that fastball by him on 3-1. So now we've got a battle on our hands.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Ball four, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Here's Corey Seager, career line against Greinke. He carries a .421 batting average, and of those hits, three of them were of the home run variety. This is on the ground over to first. One there to Gurriel, and they get them both. A chance now for the Los Angeles Dodgers starting lineup. Mark, what's your take on him against one of the best starters in the game?
Matty, you take a look at this lineup, I find myself thinking back to my playing days when I knew I had the ace on the mound. It had to be win day, and when you get in the car to drive to the yard, you tell yourself, even though you felt bad about it, just get two or three. All the pressure's on the big boy to have to execute, and usually does. Look for this lineup to try and execute and score, manufacture one or two runs early in this one.
Right side. Gurriel brings it in. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So a good start here for Zach Greinke. And now the Astros will go to work for the first time. No score. Trevor Bauer is on the mound here on the road for Game 1 of the World Series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
This will be interesting. This guy won the NL Cy Young Award last year. He's a solid pitcher, man. One of the things he does, he throws the ball into the strike zone, and he's not afraid of contact. Solid pitcher.
Here comes the second baseman, Jose Altuve, to get things kicked off in the home half of inning number one. Two balls and a strike to Jose Altuve.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it,
He'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Hit to short. He's got it. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
So frustrating, Giro. You make a good pitch, and you get these guys that can run around, and they're fast. You think you have an out, and all of a sudden, it turns into an infield single.
Yeah, this is definitely part of his game, the ground attack, Dan. He's a speedster. He's going to get a ton of infield singles, and he knows how frustrated that pitcher is.
And the runner back easily. So now to the plate, Alex Bregman. Pitch inside, the throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease.
Some managers treat the postseason as a time to be aggressive, and that's exactly the case here. They had the speed burner on the move, and it worked out nicely for him. Just got to drive him in now.
Two and two.
Two and two.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Man at second with one down, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Altuve, the runner at second with one away. Dribbled down the third baseline. Next 1-2 pitch. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning.
Batting four.
Time now for a quick look at the hometown Astros starting lineup. Anybody catch your eye, Dan?
Yeah, I think Yordan Alvarez is certainly a guy we could be excited to see play. He's hit 5 home runs in his last 10 games, so he's got to be oozing with confidence right now. He's the guy in that lineup that these pitchers have to hold down if they're going to even try to be successful.
Standing in now, Carlos Correa. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. One left for Houston. We are still scoreless. Against Greinke, he's totaled 13 base hits in 26 at-bats. Two of those hits were for home runs. Here it comes on 1-1. Bounce towards the mound. On the first, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Time for a look at the Stros on deck. And let's take a look at Carlos Correa. I had an old friend say to me one time, this is what they look like, and this is exactly what it looks like. The ability to play gold glove defense and hit in the middle of the order, I smell a potential Hall of Fame career.
Into the box now, Will Smith. There's a swing and a missile sent out to center field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And with two away here in game one of the World Series, let's give you a little refresher course at the roads these two teams took to get where they are tonight. So the bases are empty with two gone now, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is strike two anyway. And it's fouled away. Try again, 1-2. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. Dodgers down in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. The 1-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys, because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Fouled off. Short, hit hard. And that's the second out.
Batting 7, the right fielder, Kyle Tucker.
Two down, no one on base. And in to hit next will be the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. Bottom of the second here with no score. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Bauer sets his sights on his way with the 3-2. And he watches a called third strike on the cut fastball that time, and that will retire the side. The love of the game runs deep with these folks. Back with more from Game 1 after this. So here is A.J. Pollock, career line against Greinke. He's totaled 4 hits in 16 tries. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. Hit to first. Gurriel scoops it up. And he'll flip this on to Greinke, covering for the out.
Not a lot you can do with that pitch. That fastball just ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
So the next to bat will be Matt Beatty. Third inning, no score to this point.
Nope.
And this is low, ball 2. 2-1.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Throw on to first is in time, and Grinke's got himself 2 outs.
Batting 9, the second baseman, Gavin Slump.
Next up for Los Angeles, Gavin Lux. His guy's still looking at a 0 in the hit column. Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. Softly hit toward the hole. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Miles Straw. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
Well-located fastball right there. If he can continue to do that, he'll pitch deep into this one.
Lifted in the air out to left field. Pollock has a read on it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Batting 9, the catcher, Jason Castro.
Stepping up is Jason Castro. Now the 2-1.
Ball.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by. But on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
Now at the plate, here is Jose Altuve. Our score. He wanted to go after the slider, but he holds off. 3-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor. 3-1.
A little bouncer. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Another full count pitch home. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone. So you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
And that'll bring up the former first-rounder Alex Bregman, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Castro at second. Altuve is over at first with one away. A swing, and he pops him up on the infield. And the infield fly rule will be in effect here.
The left fielder, number 23. Michael Brantley.
And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. 0-for-1 here in the early going. Here's the 1-1. Swing, high drive, deep down the left field line. This ball is slicing, and that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. Tag is there, and he's out trying to score from first as the second run. A run, a hit, and a man left. On to the fourth now in game number one. Astros lead this one 1-0. To the plate now, Mookie Betts. This is foul right side. Just off the end of the bat, it's a foul ball, and he'll stick around.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Strong. Slide over and put this one away, and that's out number one. Next at the plate will be Corey Seager. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. 2-2. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. And there are two away now. And so after getting the ground ball with the fastball on that last pitch, that'll segue perfectly to our pitch speed comparison for these two starters. And that'll illustrate just how different these pitchers are. You can see 95 is the top speed for one starter, with the other topping out at just 89. Up next, Justin Turner. Two away in the inning, and Dan, it looks like this could be another 1-2-3 inning for him.
Yeah, he has really found a groove on the mound, and it's been impressive to watch. It'll be interesting to see how long he can keep this dominance up.
Fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And a good pitch, but it misses here and moves the count back to even on the Dodger third baseman, 2-2. On the ground to the right side. Oh, look at the sliding stuff. Takes it himself, and he got him. Dodgers down in order. They're down 1-0. And we're back in Houston. Welcome back to Minute Maid Park as we check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros' offense with Houston's manager. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready now is Carlos Correa, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Swing and a miss. Good sinking action there. 1-2. Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take. And he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch. And even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
In now, Yordan Alvarez. A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two.
That was a good job tying him up inside on that strikeout pitch. It wasn't even in the strike zone, but with the hitter protecting with two strikes, that's the kind of pitch you can get him to offer at, and he's probably not going to do much with it when he does make contact.
At the plate, Yuli Gurriel lays off the fastball low, and it goes to two balls and a strike. One run, two hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Offers it that one a little late, and it's 2-2 now.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
Fastball, well outside.
Hey, they tried to tie him up on that last pitch, so I like that they went away with this one. The execution didn't work, but I like the idea behind it.
Two pitch. And a good swing there as this is deep down the line and right, but this is going to wind up out of play. Bauer into his motion with the payoff pitch. And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
Stepping in once again is Kyle Tucker. 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up. Gurriel leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. There's a fastball on the inner third taken for a strike. Throw over to the bag, and the runner back in standing. Here's the 1-2. High in the air down the right field line.
but this is going to wind up a foul ball. Two out with the man at first. Lifts it into the air to shallow center.
Seager
onto the grass. He makes the catch. What a play on the run to end the inning. Astros lead one, but they're up 1-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
All right, Heidi, thank you. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And that'll bring forward Cody Bellinger.
Still a big bagel in that hit column. And this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now. Just rearing back and letting it go. And it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
Stepping in now, Will Smith. Swing and misses. He pulled the string on him, 1-2.
Wow, that changeup is an absolute beaut. They call it the great equalizer for a reason.
Out in front of a fastball as this is ripped down the left field line. That's going to be a fair ball.
Hey, this team has been shut down offensively up until this point, Dan. But right here, team's first hit of the game in the fifth inning. Let's see if it sparks them offensively.
You know, this will be interesting, D-Row, to see if they can crack this guy's code. A lot of times, once you get that first hit, several will begin to fall after that one. So it'll be interesting to see if this guy can put the screws on this one and tighten things up and not allow any more base hits.
Two balls and a strike now. No runs, just one hit. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Sent out to straightaway center field. Strong is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Now back, left fielder, DJ Pollock.
Now to the plate, A.J. Pollock. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. The 1-1. Fouls this one off. Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. This is in the air out to right. Tucker waits on it. And he makes the play to end the inning. Dodgers lead one. It remains 1-0. Striding in for Houston, Miles Straw. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
standing in now, Jason Castro. Rolled slowly down the first baseline. And there's out number two.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner that time, and that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over it.
Into the box now, Jose Altuve. Now Altuve connects. Deep left field. Back goes Pollock, and that one is gone! A solo shot here to left, and the Astros have taken a 2-0 lead.
We were wondering who was going to strike first with the long ball. What a moment for him right there. A home run in the World Series, no one can ever take that away from him.
So now to the plate, Alex Bregman. Fly ball out toward left center field. Pollock has a read on it. And he makes the catch to retire the side. 1 scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. 5 innings complete. It's now 2-0 Houston. Top half of the 6th about to get started, and standing in is the DH, Matt Beattie. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. All even now, 2-2. Again, another foul ball. Two-two one more time. High in the air down the right field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Oh, he squares this one nicely, and it's lined into center field for a leadoff single. Only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, Matt, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
Into the box, Gavin Lux.
Yep,
and this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
Well, these guys haven't had too many opportunities yet to test the running game in this one, so they could decide to put a man in motion right here.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. Altuve for one. To Gurriel, and they get them both.
It's hard to do anything with a pitch like that that's below the zone. And if you do do anything with it, most of the time, this will be the result. A double play on a good pitch down in the zone.
In now, Mookie Betts. Hit the other way out toward right field. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here. They're down 2-0. Of the inning now, and that brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder Michael Brantley. And it's fouled away. So 1-2. Swung on and missed, strike three.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Stepping in now, Carlos Correa. Outside, 2-1.
Couple of strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Astros shortstop in front with a 3-1 count.
And this is where he's especially dangerous, because if you walk him, he can steal a base on you. But if you lay a fastball in there, he can take you deep too.
3-1 is a fastball, and he can't connect. 3-2. And he looks at ball four now. So he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of a steal when he's on base.
The batter, number 44, designated hitter.
So a runner at first now with one away. And that'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. Correa, base runner at first with one out. Hard hit ball to short. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And that's the second out.
Now batting, first baseman, Yulieski Gurriel.
So a runner at second, two down now. And digging in to bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses above the zone for a ball. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. The 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. One left for Houston, as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Here's Corey Seager. And guys, seventh inning already. Hey, I'm not complaining, but this one's been flying by.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, Matt. That's what you get when both starting pitchers have it working. Neither of them have been nibbling around the strike zone at all, and they've trusted their defense to make the plays, and they've done just that.
Yeah, and it's resulted in a game that could really go either way in these late innings. A ball and two strikes. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Fastball taken high for a ball.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first down.
He's been in total control out there tonight. Gets the leadoff guy with a strike out there, and it just seems like we've seen so many off-balance swings and weakly hit balls in this one.
Justin Turner. And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-2. Through 6 1/3, Greinke still working on a shutout. And he gets under this one as the ball is skied into very shallow right. Catch made there by Altuve, and there are two gone now.
The center fielder, number 35, Cody Bellinger.
So here's Cody Bellinger. He's hitless in the game, as is much of the rest of his team. Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit sharply on the ground. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
And to keep the inning alive with a base hit, but you can see that's only the third hit. He's given up the entire game, so he's still in total control out there.
Standing in now, Will Smith, fouled off.
So far, this has been a terrific outing for this guy. Throwing well, keeping his pitches to a minimum, locating his fastball to both sides of the plate, good command of the off-speed pitches, very little traffic on the bases. So far, he couldn't have drawn up to be any better than he has been so far in this one.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. One left for L.A. They trail it here 2-0. Victor Gonzalez will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 81, Victor Gonzalez.
And now, Kyle Tucker flew out last time up.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
But quick reactions at the hot corner take away a hit, and there's one gone.
Now batting, number 3.
Next, it'll be Miles Straw. He went down on strikes last time up. Good action on the sinker, 1-2. And now some action in that Dodger bullpen as a left-hander has begun to get loose. The 1-2. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And he makes the throw to first. Strong is retired, 2 down now.
Now batting, catcher, Jason Castro.
Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. He grounded out last time up. The 1-1 home. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball. On the ground to second. Reined in. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Astros go down 1-2-3, but they're on top 2-0. Set to get underway, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter Max Muncy. And that misses 2-1. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, 3 balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing, and there it goes. He got all of that ball. Solo shot to right center as they cut the lead in half. It's 2-1 now.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows. Finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat. Being shut out all game, but not anymore.
Here comes the Houston manager out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to make a change here, as that's going to be all tonight for Zach Greinke. So as he leads with the bases empty, he stands to be the winning pitcher here tonight if the bullpen can hold up the one-run lead. Pedro Baez is on the pitch here in the eighth with nobody out. So now to the plate, A.J. Pollock. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
You like the modern style of baseball, here it is. Both starters kept their teams in the game. It's close right now. Now we hand it over to the nasty bullpens. Let's see what matchups are going to take place.
Now the 3-2 pitch. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking. And there are the final numbers for the Astros starting pitcher. He really delivered a fantastic postseason performance.
Matty B, really a solid performance. 7 strong innings pitched, in line for the win. Needs some help for the bullpen to close this one out.
At the plate now, Matt Beatty. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. One out, nobody on. And a slider's in for a strike. It's 2-2.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
The 2-2. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Altuve moving to his left, and that's the second out of the inning.
Now that the second baseman, Gavin.
The batter will be Gavin Lux. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Fly ball right down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Two out, nobody on. Fouled away. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. One for the Dodgers on the solo home run. Bottom of the eighth coming up. It's the Astros 2 and the Dodgers 1. Corey Knebel is on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 46, Corey.
So the Houston lineup turns over, and to the plate, Jose Altuve. 2 hits and 2 trips for him thus far.
Well, Matt, this is one of the problems. This guy's a good fastball, particularly low fastball hitter. It doesn't matter how hard or how low you throw it. That's right into this wheelhouse. What you want to do with this guy is move the ball from the belt up to get him to chase something that maybe he'll pop up in the infield.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
People always talk about how important getting the leadoff men on base is, and it's true. So in the eighth inning of a one-run game, that's a really nice job of attacking a hitter and sending him packing.
Into the box now, Alex Bregman. Close there, but he doesn't get the call with the breaking ball. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Here now the 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Now the payoff pitch home. Fly ball out to straightaway center. Bellinger's under it. Two gone.
The left fielder, number 23, Michael Brantley.
Next to hit, Michael Brantley struck out in his last trip to the plate. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Swung on and missed.
One ball,
that strike two.
Two strikes.
Hey, this could be a huge momentum swing for this team right here. Relief pitcher has come busting through the gates and done his job. Try and get.
Swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They lead it 2-1. Ryan Pressly comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 55, Ryan.
Set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Mookie Betts.
Hey, it's never easy scoring runs against a closer, but this lineup is setting up perfectly right now as the leadoff hitter leads off this inning.
Swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Stepping in now, Corey Seager. One ball and two strikes to count.
Big fastball is definitely this guy's MO coming out of the bullpen.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so it's working full now at 3-2.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Into the box, Justin Turner. And he fouls this one off. A sold-out crowd of 40,950 ready to lift off here in the Space City. Misses ball two. Should the lead hold up in this one, the win would belong to Zach Greinke. The Dodgers down to their final strike.
2-2 pitch is fouled away.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk it, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Man, we were treated to a nice pitcher's duel in this one. Both starters throwing strikes. They worked deep, and both were in command of the game. It really came down to a few key at-bats. This was a fun game to watch.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The Houston Astros win the World Series opener and take a 1-0 lead. Zach Greinke is the winning pitcher of record. Trevor Bauer pitched well, allowing only two earned, but ends up taking the loss. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 2 runs on 3 hits. No errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Dodgers, 1 run, 4 hits. No errors. They left 2 men on base. The winning pitcher is Zach Greinke. The loss goes to Trevor Bauer. Time of the ballgame, 2 hours and 40 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Minute Maid Park, 41,168. The Astros thank you for attending and remind you to please drive home safely. Good night.